Hello, my name is Graham Chow, and this is a quick overview of the Spur Gear Creator add-in. I'm just enabling it here. And the add-in's created in the Create menu. So I'll just bring this up. Okay, the Spur Gear Creator is really designed for creating wooden or plastic gears that have a significant undercut. And so this Creator really addresses that. Okay, so the parameters are pretty much what you would expect in specifying a spur gear. You've got pressure angle, number of teeth, diametral pitch, which is the inverse of the module. So if you change one, you change the other. Okay, these next three parameters are derived from the above parameters, and they're there just to give you a guide as to what will be created. The gear thickness is how thick the gear is, if you like, perpendicular to a bird's eye view of the gear. The clearance is the distance between the top of a tooth in one gear and the bottom of the fillet in the other gear. So that's sort of just the clearance between the sort of top and bottom of the teeth. The hole diameter is used to specify a hole in the middle of the gear. If you set this to zero, it won't create a hole. The center cross is there to specify a cross in the center of the gear, and it's really there to be compatible with some certain building plastic building block toys you can get. Okay, and create holder is there for when you're routing out the gear. So what would happen is you would route out one side and you'd want to turn it around and hold it and route out the other side. That's what that's about. So let's just create the gear. And it looks pretty much like a gear. And let me just move this to the side. And I'll create a holder. This diagram below is just to give you a visualization of what the module means. It's simply the distance between the teeth times pi. Okay, this is the holder, and you can see if I move the gear back over it, the gear sort of nicely fits in. So the holder itself is really a template that you would use to cut out the actual holder. So it's kind of like the inverse. In reality, when you are creating the holder, you would make it slightly larger than the original gear. It really depends on how tight you want to hold that gear when you're milling out the other side. Okay, so that's the end of the demonstration. Thanks for listening, and I hope you find it useful.